Well, g'day. I'm speaking to you from my office at Parliament, where it's a beautiful sunny day and I've come back from question time. And what is becoming very clear already in this first week of Parliament, as we debate the Prime Minister's statement to the House on Tuesday, is a real contrast between the parties and a clear difference between what we are saying. Showing, I think, that this is going to be a very important election for the future of New Zealand. A choice really between, I think, a very aspirational party in the National Party, where we understand that to get where we want to go and have a more prosperous and a brighter future for all New Zealanders, we need clear, responsible economic policy that lays a platform for businesses to be able to feel confident about taking on more people, and that keeps pressure off the Reserve Bank so that actually New Zealanders have lower interest rates, lower inflation in the years going ahead. We're very much about creating policies that allow this country to create and mould its own destiny rather than have a destiny that is shaped by foreign lending institutions and the like. Versus a party, I think, in Labour and whatever coalition it could cobble together, that really does advocate more spending, more tax, and more borrowing, which again I think amounts to less choices for the future as we see credit downgrades and higher interest rates, arguably, and less choices, as I say, and the cost of money costs more. I think we're also seeing very different styles from the leaders. And I think at John Key, what is becoming very clear is we have a non-traditional politician who's prepared to do what's right, prepared to be very straightforward with the electorate in a way I don't know if we've seen before. And so already this year, we've had from the Prime Minister the announcement of an election date of 26 November, much sooner, some 10 months before that day, much sooner than we've ever seen an announcement before. Effectively, he's giving away a tactical advantage, and he's doing that because he wants this country in the lead up to the Rugby World Cup and then the election to have certainty to be able to get that Rugby World Cup and that showcasing of our country to the world absolutely right. We've also seen him roll out New Zealand First, led by Winston Peters. And again, he's made it very clear, we want to be a party that's about going forward and about our future rather than our past. And again, I think you see a very straightforward approach and a desire to tell the electorate what we're going to do in a straightforward way. Let the voters know so that there's no surprises, so that voters have certainty. And we believe, I think, that voters have a right to know who we might go with. So, all in all, a very interesting year, a really interesting start to it with statements from the Prime Minister, a great speech by him on Tuesday, and now a debate going on in the House about that statement, a clear set of contrasts, and I think a choice for a party that is building a brighter future by economic growth, by getting the fundamentals in place economically, by also doing things to make the public service smart and get value for money there. And at that choice versus, as I say, the other side, which has a quite different set of policies that ultimately amount to more tax, more borrowing, and less say over this country's future. Mm-hmm.